2012 is the year of our Lord and Savior, Sword Art Online. It would go on to be one of the most recognizable and beloved franchises, sparking a revolution in the fantasy genre we now to be known called as isekai, meaning different world. It's a genre of light novel, manga, anime, or video game that revolved around a normal person from Earth being displaced or transported or otherwise trapped into a parallel universe, fantasy world, or virtual world. If we want to go back and be historically correct, Sword Art Online is not the first isekai, but given the cultural impact of this anime, it's hard to look before it and call any other anime the father of isekai. Well, that's what you think. If Sword Art Online is the father of isekai, then it's fair to call Mushoku Tensei as the grandfather of isekai. And while SAO sparked the isekai genre in 2012, Mushoku Tensei was already well more established and frankly wrote the book on isekai. You see, Mushoku Tensei isn't following the trends of isekais. They just are isekai itself. There have been many interesting concepts that come along over the years. Overpowered leads, becoming an adventurer, magic academies, elves, and other creatures, as well as more adult themes and dark plot points. And this anime uses them in the proper way, not using them as a gimmick, but something really a part of the story and world. Now, let's address the elephant in the room. Isekais have gotten saturated, with the genre averaging at least 5 isekais a year, so it's easy to see why. But every so often, we get an isekai that reshapes the genre itself. This year we get one of the legends in the genre, coming to show what it means to actually be an isekai. So for me to already say Mushoku Tensei is the best isekai this year, it's not that far-fetched. I would be willing to say this could be the big three of isekais, or at least fighting for that position. Without a doubt, I think this one will not only be the best isekai this year, but will have you come to appreciate the great ones when you see it. Now, let's get down to business. Why you should watch Mushoku Tensei, but please be warned, I will be including a lot of spoilers about the anime. This is a very important illustration point to me to get into the plot. I need to talk about these characters because they are the story. So if you don't like spoilers, go watch the anime and come back here. I will also be diving into the manga heavily, so you've been warned. Mushoku Tensei, Jobless Reincarnation, I Will Seriously Try If I Go to Another World, is a light novel series by Rifujin Na Magono. He published this originally online on a website for amateur and new writers to get their start, called Shosetsuka ni Naro, which translates to Let's Become a Novelist. Back in November 2012, this website is the biggest in Japan, where you could read novels for free, packed with some of your favorite animes at the time. That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime, The Irregular at Magical High School, The Rising of the Shield Hero, Konosuba, ReZero, and trust me, many, many more of your favorite isekais came from this website. Almost all of them start here. This is a great source to get new and up-and-coming talent. At its highest, it was ranked the number one novel on the site. A year later, it was announced that the series would be receiving a print release under Media Factory's MF Book imprint, with illustrations done by Pixiv, the user called Shirotaka. A manga adaptation by Yuka Fujikawa began serialization in June 2014. Issues of the monthly comic Flapper, the Seven Seas Entertainment licensed the Tenkaban volumes of the manga for localization in North America. The company has also licensed the original light novels. On Sayaseta's rankings, the web novel has made cumulative appearances as the most popular work on the website. That's extremely high praises. Think about it. Thousands on top of thousands of novels being sent there to this website, and this anime is ranked above all of them. That's quite the feat. Some of your favorite animes of all time have been on this website to get their start, and this anime, this isekai, was ranked over all of them at some point, and is still to this day the most popular work on the website. Does that not get you interested into watching Mushoku Tensei? Well, it should. So let's start with the plot. The plot starts out somewhat familiar, or similar to likes of That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime, but it's different. In fact, you would say That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime took it from Mushoku Tensei. You see, this anime at the time does not hold back at pertaining to the character's life, to their death, and I wouldn't put it into the dark spectrum of ReZero or The Rising of the Shield Hero. It does have that grit element to it, which is highlighted by the art style that they chose. Rudy is a 34-year-old shut-in. He's labeled as an underachiever by the author. After 17 years, his parents kicked him out of the house. They wanted to highlight how different he is already from the jump. He looks more like that ugly bastard character than an actual standard protagonist you see in most animes. After wandering around the streets, he's trying to save someone, but he ends up being ran over by a truck. Truck-kun, if you want to say. Being reincarnated as a child into a new family. And while he does have talent, he's not so different to where no one else could learn what he has. And that's kind of like an illustration point about the anime. The character doesn't start off the top just busted as the best and strongest character in the anime. Over the years, you're going to have to watch him grow up and develop into being that overpowered character to warrant being overpowered for that character. A lot of shows want to start off the gates. He gets into the new world. He has the new talent. He's the strongest right from the jump. Mushō Tensei doesn't operate that way. Rudy is not perfect, and he isn't going to be handed everything. He sees this new world as an opportunity, but he hasn't yet gotten rid of that emotion from his past life. The show wanted to highlight a bit of the harsh school environment that he was raised in. Later, you'll see, even though he tries his best, he doesn't always have the correct answer, nor is he a bashful character in any way. For example, he's quite perverted and worships his master's white panties in all their pure innocence. Now let's talk about his far from perfect family. Zeneth, Paul, Lilia, the father, the mother, and the maid, living all in the same roof, under the same house, in their early prime of their adulthood. If you're yourself an adult, I think you can already guess where this is going. And here, I'll even let you guess. These are some other tropes from other animes, so feel free to pick which one you think is the correct answer. A. They're all mean towards the maid. B. They love going out for ice cream as a family. C. They are slobs who just don't like to clean. Or D. The maid gets pregnant. Ding, ding, ding. The maid gets pregnant. Like I said, putting three adults all in their prime in the same house is going to spell trouble. With the maid and the father having history, this is the first big spoiler, even though it's going to happen relatively very soon in the anime. This really helps define characters, and now moving forward, he's going to push a point for Rudy and put something into his mind about all these characters. Individually, the mother and the father are extroverts who are former adventurers. Zeneth is a supportive mother, and Paul is the hit first, ask questions later. Emphasis on the hit. If you watch the anime, you've seen before, and spoiler, that does not change. With Rudy now being an adult in their world, but still a child, he has the mind of an adult, and he has a pretty sharp tongue, or he can be, and that does get him in trouble. Very little, I would say, as much as it should, but does get him in trouble. He says some things he maybe shouldn't say, and Paul does not like that all too much. I just want to say, punching a child in the face is not the way to go about it. They don't always have the greatest dynamic, now and in the future. Paul himself has, like I said, problems with punishing his child, alcohol, and women. Still, though, he's not the worst father, or anime father. He still sees his son's potential and tries to nurture it by giving him teachers. He sees that he needs more independence and needs to separate from Sylphie, so for the best interest of both the children, he separates them. When the family is separated forcibly, Rudy is looking at it very differently, and is thinking about the situation a lot more differently than, say, an adult would, like Paul, causing a less-than-stellar reunion. Next, let's talk about the love interest for the shows. So, Sylphie, Eris, Roxy, childhood friend, his first love, and his main love, for now. Spoilers. Sylphie is his first friend he saves from being bullied, who's then transported after the big incident away from her family. Honestly, Rudy does forget about her quite a lot, and he doesn't really care moving forward, albeit this character will be really a part of the story, say in season 2 and moving forward. Roxy, his first master that he worships, she finds herself motivated to train because of his early talent and feeling that she could do better. Later on, we'll be spending most of her time thinking about him and his family. I honestly don't know how this is going to end with her. And lastly, I'll talk about Eris, his main love. She, for some reason, reminds me a lot of Raftalia. She, for a long time, has to rely and trust on Rudy. They further get involved, and this is where you're expecting some sort of real happy ending, a cut the credits, a clap it off end type of ending. And I won't try and spoil anything more about it much more. I'll just say that they really try to develop their character even further, to really tell more of a full, deviant, and cohesive story of that these characters aren't done in their early teens. They have much, much more to their own individual story that they can offer. Like I said with the other characters, I don't know exactly how it's going to end. Now I'll get to someone that the anime hasn't yet covered, Rudyard. He has this inner darkness about him that no one could exactly help. He's a killer, and I mean a killer. Instinct is to kill, and he's very a scary figure in the show. And there will be times where you just don't know if Rudy's going to be safe with him. Rather, anyone's going to be safe around him. It's not like he's not trustworthy, it's just that that inner darkness is such a terrifying presence to where people can't really stand with him most of the time. Rudy needs his help to actually survive, and Bridger needs Rudy's help because there is something that only he can help him with. I'm going to move on now to the world, the meat of the story. The story for the first season is going to be taking place after the teleportation incident. This is an incident you probably don't know about yet, but right now you're watching what happens before it. After the incident, you'll really see how dangerous the world can actually be, how Rudy actually has to not just develop, just grow up in general. When they said he has to be an adult by 12, the world really means it. And another illustration point of how dangerous the world is, you're gonna early on see how a princess could be nearly stomped to death, very brutally, like nothing. Like it was easy to get to her in general. This was a downright brutal scene that happened early on, reminding me a lot of the Videl scene in Dragon Ball Z. Sure, she gets healed up very quickly, but so does the Videl. The thing that you take away is that image that you can't really forget. Later, you're gonna learn about the seven great powers in this world, who are literally the gods with terrifying powers. The mere mention of their name is a signal for your own death or demise. And know about the Reno Magic Academy, the school where Roxy mentions earlier on in the anime. Like I said earlier at the beginning, this isn't a gimmick. They really try and develop these points very slowly early on into the anime. And like I mentioned before, you're gonna learn all about what it means to be an isekai, the whole fantasy world itself, through watching this anime. And I wanna talk about the source material. What's noticeably different between this anime and others in the genre is the pace setting. The pace is thoughtful and really well planned out. In the books, it's easy to find and easy to see where the time periods start and end. And here is no different. We really get to grow with the character. We start out seeing him as a baby, to watch him then grow up as a young adult. The audience is really along for the ride, making the story easy to be a part of. The source material is vast and really the selling point of why you're watching this world and this character. In the past, I've mentioned how animes have enough source material to get X amount of seasons, but this one is different. The material is not just good, but great. So instead of great first seasons and a mediocre second or third, this one could have three great seasons. So what is my opinion slash review on Mushoku Tensei? Overall, I want to say that this anime has the potential to be a 4 out of 5 in my opinion. Now, granted, this is my own personal scale, and I think a lot of you should also keep it to your own personal taste and scaling to where you think animes are rated or should be rated at. So for my preference of where I put my 1 through 5 of from 1 being one of the worst animes ever made that can be called an anime to 5 an absolute masterpiece, I think it definitely could sit at 4. But for right now, I definitely can put it at a 3.5. So I think that's going to do it for the video in general. I hope you do like the video. If you did like the video, please make sure to like the video, God, YouTube stuff. But yeah, like the video, as well as maybe considering subscribing to the channel. I do mainly talk about older animes and talking about why they don't get season 2s or maybe more information around animes in general, older animes. But I do like coming back and talking about the more relevant and new animes coming out because I do watch pretty much all the animes that always come out. I just don't always make a video about them. But yeah, that's gonna do it for the video. Barry Anime out. Oh, also, if you have any questions about the video, I liked having my sources down in the description down below, but I'm going to make sure to tell you here that if you want to go check out any of the resources for the videos, always just go make sure to check out my description. I always try to give you my resources so you know I'm giving you factual information, on the topic. So yeah, Barry Anime out. Peace.